Hi and welcome to the third video in this series of computer vision mini projects. So the last video gave us the location of our face along with the dimensions we need to resize the filter to. So we're going to use those dimensions in this video and resize our filter to perfectly fit the dimensions of our face. So let's head over right to the code and let's get started. Right, so the filter being rescaled, now let's decide the position of the filter. So the x1 coordinate of the filter, I want it to be centered according to the x-axis. So face x1, let's take the x1 coordinate, sorry about that, x1 coordinate, and then add to it the value of half the value of my face width and subtract half the value of filter width which we just calculated. Right, so filter x1 was pretty easy, but filter y1 is a little more complex, and yet again it depends on the filter which we're using. So the formula for this would be the y1 coordinate minus integer of the height of my filter into 0.22. So in this case, the 0.22 factor which I have here happens to be a scale factor, and it's going to vary with respect to different filters. So how it works is, if you increase the scale, the filter is going to shift upwards. So use it accordingly based on the image of the filter which you have. For example, if something that's around your head needs to be filtered, then make sure that the value is more. But if something around your mouth, for example, a mustache or something, is filtered, accordingly half the value, which is to be less than 0.22. So next thing which we're going to do is we're going to load the alternate diagonal again. So that's x1 plus width, and for y2 it's y2 plus height. Filter height. So x, w and y, h are basically like our pairs. So we have decided the position of our filter. Okay, so now let's, in case our filter goes out of frame, we need to account for those changes, right? So let's check for frame in this section. So I want my coordinates to be in between 0 and the width and height of my image, that is my face. So let's do that here. If filter x1 is less than 0, then filter x1 needs to be 0. So this will ensure that its value is never goes beyond 0. So I want similar thing for y1 as well, and okay, so in this case it's going to be y1 being compared to 0 and then again it being 0. Now it's the turn of the filter x2, that is our right corner. So filter x2 should never exceed our image width, right? So it should always, if it is greater than image width, then convert it into image width, filter x2. And if, now similar thing about y2 should always be less than the image height. So if it crosses image height, make sure it's equal to image height. Right, so this has basically bounded my filter in between 0 and 0, 0 and image width comma image height coordinates. So if there's any changes in those, we need to account for those changes. So filter width is equals to, so basically width is between x2 minus x1, filter x2 minus filter x1, and height is going to be in between filter y2 and filter y1. Okay, these shouldn't be in the for if statement, they should be out of the if statement. So let me paste them here, get out of the if. Oh, sorry about this, need to retype it. So accounting for the changes is filter width is equals to filter x2 minus filter x1. So anything that's between x2 and x1 is our filter width, and filter height is equals to filter y2 minus filter y1. So far, yes, the code is looking correct and the changes are accounted for. So height and width is, again, we have a height and width of the filter. So now that we have our height and width, let us resize our filter, right, according to the height and width which we need. So let's name this section as resizing the filter. Okay, so the filter name is dog. It's stored in the variable dog. So dog is equals to cv2.resize, and what am I resizing? Dog. And what do I need to resize it to? It's filter width, comma, filter height variables, which we just calculated. And the method I'm going to use is dot inter area. Okay, so we need to resize not just our filter but also our masks, right? Because they basically are filters and they're going to act as our filters to some extent. So let's do that. And so first thing which we're going to resize is our original mask, which I showed, the black and white image, and original mask inverse as well. So let's store it under mask and mask inverse respectively. There's mask inverse. Lot of typos today. Okay, so filters are resized, and next we can extract a region of interest. We don't want the entire feed basically. We just need to do with around where our face is detected, right? Because that's why we'll be inserting the filter. So it's the region between y1 y2 and x1 x2. So as I said, this is basic Python slicing, and NumPy does recognize images as numbers, so you can apply arithmetic operations to those, as we're going to be doing later also in this the function which we use later. So this is my region of interest between y1 y2, and let's make that y2 y1. Don't want complications later. So in this video, we were able to position our filter and also sort of bind it to the numerical coordinates which mark the extremities of our face. And we finally resized it to the dimensions which we calculated on the basis of different location coordinates of our face as well as the filter. So in the upcoming video, which is going to also mark the completion of our series, we will place this filter exactly where it needs to be and also successfully conclude our project. So I'll be seeing you there in the final video.